the Christian Center worship service today as we continue our series In His Presence by our very own Dr. Linda Bradford. So we invite all of our Facebook and YouTube listeners to join in with us and share on your page. We also ask that you just get excited about God's word. In His presence, there's healing, there's deliverance. So all we have to do is just keep pressing forward and trust and believe in His word, and your deliverance, healing is done. It's done. We just have to receive it.
Father God, we thank you, Lord God. We bless your name, oh God. We thank you for this service today, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for those that are on their way, Lord God. And Lord God, we thank you for those that are in the sanctuary, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for those that are watching via YouTube and Facebook Live this morning, Lord God. Lord God, we invoke your presence here today, Lord God. We welcome you into the sanctuary, Lord God. We welcome you into the house of God today, Lord God. We thank you for your presence, Lord God. It is where your presence, Lord God, that healing will take place, Lord God. That deliverance will take place, Lord God. That the captives will be set free, Lord God. We thank you right now in advance, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for the word that will go forth today by the woman of God. Lord God, saturate her with your anointing power, Lord God. Lord God, we give you praise, Lord God, that we'll be receptive to your word today, Lord God. And we'll be mindful to give you all the praise, Lord God, all the honor and all the glory. In Jesus' name, somebody shout amen.
Holy, mighty, worthy of the glory,
the holy,
holy, mighty, worthy of the glory.
Help me lift him up.
him up. Help me lift 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 him up. Higher and higher.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
Which come in my head. Didn't he give you a reason to give him glory? Did he give you a reason to give him praise? I don't know what he's done for you, but for the mere fact, the mere fact that I walked up in here today, I don't know about you. I don't know what you've been through. Come on. I don't know what you're dealing with. But if God allowed you to get up, if God allowed you to walk on in here, if God allowed you to drive here, come on, through danger seen and dangers unseen, and we got to pump you up to tell you I will bless the Lord.
Come on.
If anything, y'all need to be telling somebody, get up off me. You don't know what I've been through. Come on, I got a right to praise him. This altar ought to be filled with people, come on, who have a breakthrough praise. Yes. Now we're going to give y'all one more time to think about something God has done for you that he deserves to have an I will bless the Lord praise. See, this ain't about me. This ain't about Sister Sherry. This ain't about nobody. This is between you and God. So if you got something to praise him for, come on, get out your comfort zone. Wake your way. Come on, make your way. Come on, this is the pool. The altar is the pool. Come on, step on in the pool and get your praise on this morning. Come on, that's it. Whoa. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
I thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
I thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
I thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Pick me up.
I will bless the Lord.
Turn me around.
I will bless the Lord.
Place my feet.
I will bless the Lord.
Solid ground.
I will bless the Lord.
I will give it glory.
I will bless the Lord.
I will give you honor.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will give you glory.
I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
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 I will bless the Lord.
Save my children.
I will bless the Lord.
Protected my family.
I will bless the Lord.
Woo!
I will bless the Lord.
I don't know.
I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Talk about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Help me.
I will bless the Lord.
In my right mind.
I will bless the Lord.
Help me.
I will bless the Lord.
In my right mind.
I will bless the Lord.
Talk about something.
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 I will bless the Lord.
He picked me up.
I will bless the Lord.
In a marriage
way. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord.
You're standing here today.
I will bless the Lord.
Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
Praise
him. I will bless the Lord.
I thank God.
I will bless the Lord.
Grace and mercy.
I will bless the Lord.
Heard about something.
I will bless the Lord.
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 Thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
I thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
I thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
I thought about something.
I will bless the Lord.
In the building.
I will bless the Lord.
In God's glory.
I will bless the Lord.
I'm in the
building. I will bless the Lord.
Giving God praise.
I will bless the Lord.
Some people can't.
I will bless the Lord.
Some people choose.
I will bless the Lord.
Some people just
I will bless the Lord.
But I
will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
He is done.
He has done great things for me, so I will.
He is done.
He has done great things for me, so I will.
He is done.
He has done great things for me, so I will.
He is done.
He has done great things for me, so I will.
He is done.
He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me.
Yes,
he has done great things for me. He has done great things for me, so I will bless the Lord.
I choose to
bless the
bless
Lord.
Lord. Oh, I bless your name. Oh, I bless your name, Jesus. I bless your name, Jesus. Woo. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, I bless your name, Lord. Oh, I bless your name, Jesus. Come on, he's been so good. He's been so good. He's been so good. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah, 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 yeah.
I lift my hands in total adoration unto you.
Yeah.
You reign on the throne. For you are God and God alone. Because of you, my cloudy days are gone.
Yeah.
I can sing to you this song.
Woo!
I just want to say that I love you more than anything. I lift my hand and go to that adoration.
Yeah.
For you are God, God alone. I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Everybody say it one time. Say it.
I lift my hands in total adoration unto you.
You
reign on the throne, for you are God and God alone. Because of you, my God. I can sing to you this song.
I just want to say
that I love you more than anything. I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything.
Lift your voice and tell him, say, I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
Hey.
I worship and adore you.
I just want
to
tell
you. Lord, I love you more than anything.
You really love Jesus. Lift your voice, everybody. Say, I love
you, Jesus.
Oh,
I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. Jesus, I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything.
Say, I love
you, Jesus.
I worship
and adore you.
I just want to tell you,
Lord, I love you more than anything.
And just begin to love on him today. Doesn't matter how you feel. Just lift your voice and just begin to tell him how much he means to you. Hallelujah, Lord, you're wonderful. You're worthy. You're worthy. Worthy of the glory. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Anybody ever been healed in here? I dare you to praise him, make you grateful today. Oh, he keeps on making a way. Making a way. Yeah. Lord, I love you more than anything. All over the house, say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Oh.
just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything.
I love you,
Jesus.
You keep doing great and mighty things. I worship
and adore you.
I just want to tell
you. Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love
you. Lord, I love you more than anything.
Lord, I love you, yeah.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
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 Thank you, Father God. Worry it down the storm.
Go ahead with it.
Yes. Thank you, Lord God.
I let go and I let it down. Let God have His way. That's when things start happening.
Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord.
When I stop looking at that game, I let go and I let God. Let darkness
yes,
oh, we worship the name, we worship
the Lord.
Worship the name, God.
Oh, we worship
the Lord. Worship the
Lord.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. This morning, we want to continue praying for mental health, oppression, and depression. We just want to lift it up. You know, I got to be honest with you, that's like the silent killer now. It took over. And why is it the silent killer? Because the enemy don't want you to talk about what you're going through. He wants you to keep it in silence until you make that final decision and it's too late. But at Charity Christian Center, we calling out the enemy. We calling it out. We speaking to mental health, oppression, and depression. We talking to it. Because God came to heal us of oppression and depression. He came to heal us. He came to deliver us. You might be standing up, you might be sitting down, but you dealing with mental health. The enemy is attacking your mind. And the enemy wants to play in your mind over and over and over and over that you can't make it, that you're not good, that you wasn't born right, that you don't look right, that your hair not right, your skin color not right. It just keeps attacking you over and over and over again. But I come against the enemy this morning. I come against him. I come against the enemy because he wants you to stay in silence. He wants you to keep it in. But I come to give you hope this morning. I come to give you hope this morning because Jesus came to the heal of mental health. Oppression and depression is mental. Jesus came to heal them all. And we just want to pray for you this morning. I know you in here this morning. I already know because God done told me already. You in here this morning. But the enemy don't want you to walk out. He don't want you to get healed. He don't want you to get help. He wants you to keep it just locked up, just you and him. But I'm calling him out this morning. I'm calling him out this morning. I just want to pray for you. I just want to pray for you. I just want to pray for you this morning. So if you're in here this morning and you're dealing with any type of mental health, whatever it is, I just want you to walk up. Just take a bolder step and just walk up to this altar and let me pray for you this morning. Just let me walk up. Don't let the enemy keep you in silence, because he wants you to stay right there. He wants you to not move. But I'm telling you this morning, God got a breakthrough for you. God has a breakthrough for you this morning. God has a breakthrough for you. Whoever you are, I'm talking to you. You hear me and you know it's you. You know you need to move out. Don't worry about people looking at you. The one with the issue of blood didn't care who saw her. She said, I got to get to Jesus, because that's what my breakthrough. I don't care if I have to push through the crowd. I just got to get my breakthrough. I know you're in here. I know you're in here this morning. Thank you, Lord God. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you right now, Lord God. Come on, come on. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Who else? Thank you, Lord. Who else? Thank you, Father God. Go ahead, Sister Freedom. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. He don't want you to move out. But I'm talking to the enemy. I'm talking to him. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Somebody right over here. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God, right now, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father. I thank you for healing right now, Lord God. I thank you for healing right now, Lord God. Lord, I thank you for healing in this building, Father God. I thank you right now, Lord God, that you're about to turn things around right now, Father God. Right now, Lord God. Right now, Lord God. Right now, Lord God. Right now, Lord God. We talk to a mental health right now. We speak to it. Thank you, Lord God. It has no place with God's people. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. We thank you, Lord God. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God. If anyone else is in the building, Lord God. Lord, I got to thank you right now, Lord God. If I stretch my hand out, Lord God, you're moving right now, Lord God. Heal that heart, Lord God. Heal that mind, Lord God. Turn things around, Lord God. Lord, let them see the light, Father God. The light is you, Lord God. What the enemy meant for evil, Lord God, you starting to turn that around for your good, Father God. I thank you right now, Lord God. Give you glory for it right now. Thank you, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord.
Ain't no need to turn. The night is gone. It'll be all over in the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning. All over in the morning.
Sun will shine again. It will be.
It'll be all over
in the morning.
In the morning.
You'll wear a smile. It will be.
It'll be all over in the morning.
Oh.
Come on, give it up, give it up. Come on, give the Lord a hand.
In the morning.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You're about to be blessed in mind by Tia. Come on, give it up for her. Amen. She's going to do Praise Break by William Murphy this morning. Get ready for your breakthrough. Continue. Breakthroughs continue in the house. Amen. Hallelujah.
God's going to use your testimony. Well, I need somebody in here with a nasty testimony to open up your mouth. Say, I wasn't in church all my life. I did some stuff. I should have been in jail. I should have been dead. But he was lifted high. And on a tree, he lived there. I want you to praise him like what's in front of you is better than what's behind you. I want you to praise him like God's about to bless your whole family. Somebody open your mouth and somebody worship like God just erased your past. Somebody worship like God just gave you a clean slate.
God created it. I plead the blood over your
ligaments and joints. I clean the blood over your red blood cells. I clean the blood over your white blood cells. I command your sugar, I command your blood sugar to regulate in the presence of God. And I speak to every spirit that will cause mental disease. And I decree and declare that God is taking your mind back. I break the spirit of depression. I break the spirit of anxiety. I rebuke every anxiety attack. And I decree and declare that the people of God are right now free. Somebody throw your head back. There's a grace on my life to release the glory of God. Throw your hands up and open your mouth now. The glory of God is turning your situation around. The glory of God is turning your situation. I can get somebody to prophesy, because by the time you get back to Houston, it's gonna be
woo! you, Lord.
The devil tried it, but I'm still here. I'm still here. Shouting, dancing.
Woo! Church that loves to praise God, and ain't nothing wrong with it, nothing at all. Amen. You ought to give it all to Him. I promise you, things will be so much better. Amen. Can you guys hear me? Amen. Father, we thank you for this time, Lord, that you decided that your worshipers can call on you. Thank you for it, Lord. Thank you for this time. Thank you for it. Thank you for it. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. Amen. I know the spirit is high. Amen. I want you guys to take your seat for just a few minutes. Amen. I'm going to give an exhortation this morning. Amen. And we do have a baby christening this morning. So we are going to, I'm just going to do an exhortation. Somebody say, praise the Lord. It's always good when you get the word of God. Amen. Amen. Now this afternoon or this morning, I'm sorry, I'm caught up. Y'all have to give me a moment. Amen. Amen. It's, oh Lord, have mercy. Glory to God. You know, God knows what He's doing. Work. He knows what He was doing, what He's doing. I want you guys to take a moment and just raise your hand and say, Lord, I thank you. I'm in the right place at the right time. Is there anybody in here this morning that woke up in the middle of the night with something real heavy on your heart? That anybody in here that has happened to or happened to last night? Something real heavy on your heart. I'm not doing an altar call. Just want to see you. That's one, two. Anybody else? Three. Anybody else? Four. Amen. Sometimes in the middle of the night, God will wake you up. Yeah, and doesn't mean we want to wake up. Doesn't mean we want to get up, but He'll do that from time to time. I'm going to tell you this. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Amen. And so last night, amen, or yesterday, it was a real long day for me. Real long, long day. And so when I went to bed last night, you know, I was trying to get in the Word and trying to study and pray. And I just kept finding myself nodding. So I say, Lord, I can't do this. I'm so tired and sleepy, I'm going to have to go to sleep. I said, but what you could do for me is wake me up early. Wake me up either early or in the middle of the night and tell me what to tell the people. Anybody know what I'm talking about? And so last night about 1:30 in the morning, I woke up and I thought, why am I awake this time of morning? And God said, don't you remember? You told me to wake you up. So I have this topic I'm going to teach this morning, not long, and I'm going to give you about three scriptures. And the topic or the title is not something brand new. It's something I've taught in the past. But the topic is called A True Worshipper. And does that just tie in? And I say, God, thank you so very much, because the presence of God could not be so prevalent in here, come on, unless we had true worshipers in here. So this really ties in, amen, with what the subject or the topic that God has given me to teach on. Now, before I get real deep into this, which I know I can't today, but a true worshiper is a seeker. And that's a word that I want you to put in your spirit, because you've got to be a seeker to be a true worshiper. Because when you're doing in true worship, you are seeking that hiding place that God has for you. You're a seeker. Now, I don't know about you, but in the middle or as soon as I start worshiping God, it feels like a porter opens on the inside of me. Now, I'm not sure everybody, you know, but I feel that porter like opens up on the inside of me. It's like a receiving porter where I am reaching him and he's reaching me. You're a seeker. You are a seeker when you are a worshiper. Somebody say amen. Listen. When you are a seeker, this goes with some of the teaching from last week. If you are a seeker, you got passion. I want you to pay attention to the words that I'm using, because these are the words that were sitting out to me about 1 o'clock, 1:30 this morning. Amen. You have a passion, because that porter that opens up on the inside of you, it's reaching toward, amen, the power and the presence of God, amen, and drawing, amen, it into you even more. I'm telling you, amen, God wants us to be a true worshiper. Now, you can be anything else you want to be, but if you want to reach God, you got to be a true worshiper. It is no other way. We cannot do this mentally. And it's not in our hands being raised. Come on. Worshiping God has to do with what's on the inside of you. And if you don't have that on the inside of you, guess what? You're not reaching where you could go. You're not going, come on, where you're supposed to be going. So it's not about me just lifting my hands or coming up here dancing. It's about what's on the inside of you that's going to open up when you start worshiping him. Listen to me. When I worship God, come on, and worship you. Come on, I'm talking to him. I ain't talking to you. I'm worshiping God. I'm worshiping. One thing I realized, because my mom's in a nursing home, and my mom has Alzheimer's, and her mind go and come and go and come. But every once in a while, you can hear her going, I praise you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I'm telling you, if it wasn't for worship, I don't believe she would even still be here. How she has marked the nursing home, everybody in there say, that lady is a believer there. She go down the hallway worshiping the Lord. Praising God. So she's in and out. But the good thing about it is that she's worth. Y'all don't hear me. So whenever her time comes, she's ready. You understand what I'm saying? She's ready. Amen. So you got to have a passion on the inside of you for him. And I'm going to give you a word. Amen. For passion, I'm going to give you several definitions. Amen. You got to have a burning desire. Now, your passion could be for anything, and you have a burning desire for anything, but when you got a burning desire for God, then you got a real passion, baby. It's a burning desire. It's a strong desire. It's a deep desire, intensive, deep affection, come on, or a deep attraction. That's loving God. I'm going to tell you, when I'm in love with God, I can't think about what people are saying about me. Because people will say something, but one of the things you have to realize is that you got to get unhooked from that. What I found out is I can't get in the presence of God thinking about the wrong thing. Amen. You might think you got it going on. Let me see you get in his presence with the wrong thoughts, with a bad heart. Oh, no, you can't enter his presence like that. Amen. I need God. Y'all don't hear me what I'm saying this morning. I say, God, I love you. Not just because I love you. I need you more than I ever needed you before. I'm not seeking you for no money. Come on. I'm not seeking you for no house or no car. Y'all got to hear me. I'm seeking you because I need you. I can't do it without you, Lord God. I can't do it. Are we here? Okay. Here's some couple of things. I'm going to tell you two things, amen, that you need. Number one is found in the book of Matthew 5 and 6. If you got this quality, you a worshiper. If you got this quality, it's in the Amplified Bible, and it's called a hunger and a what? And a thirst. Y'all know what a hunger and a thirst is? It's one thing to be hungry. It's another thing to be thirsty. But when you got a hunger and a thirst, man, you might do some desperate things. Read for me.
Blessed. Joyful.
Watch all of these words that are being used here. Blessed. That's one.
Joyful.
Okay, you got the different translation from me. I have AMPC. Who got that? Okay, you read what you got, and then we'll let somebody else go.
Blessed, joyful, nourished by God's goodness, are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Those who actively seek right standing with God. For they will be completely.
Wait a minute. If you hunger and thirst, you will be completely what?
Satisfied.
Not partially. Have you ever eaten anything and you didn't get filled? You were partially filled. But I'm telling you, a hunger and a thirst after God, come on, that hunger and that thirst after him, amen, is going to get you satisfaction. Can you read for me, Brother Jeff?
Blessed. And fortunate. And happy. And spiritually. And prosperous.
What?
In that state in which you were born again, child of God enjoys his favor and salvation.
His favor and salvation. Do you see all of this that you receive from being hungry for him and thirsty for him? It says, blessed and fortunate and happy and spiritually prosperous, you will become. Now, here's what that means to me. Seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness, and everything else will be added to you. But God said, here, if you will pay attention, sometimes in the Bible, it repeats itself, but it repeats itself in a different way. But it repeats itself. Y'all getting it? Amen. So if you're repeating, amen, God has something for you. Yeah. And so how can I get all this stuff that God has for me? By being hungry and thirsty for him. I'm breaking it up. I'm making it as clear as I can. Read again for me, Brother Jeff.
Blessed and fortunate and happy and spiritually and prosperous in that state in which you was born again, child of God, enjoys his favor and salvation, and those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, his uprightness and right standing with God, for they shall be completely satisfied.
Is that good or what? Now, guess what? All these things that's troubling us, if we could just find our way in the presence of God. How do I get in the presence of God? By true worshiping. That is how I'm going to get in the presence of God. I'm going to worship him until I enter in. Until I enter in. I declare and decree that you're getting what I'm saying today. I'm going to worship him until I can get in his presence all the way in. Because once I open up my arms, come on my heart, amen, when the portal opens on the inside of me, immediately you ought to be able to sense something. You ought to be able to sense the presence of God. And here's what I believe. I believe that porter that's on the inside of me is like a drawing mechanism. Yeah, it draws the spirit to me. Come on, while I'm drawn to him. Anybody getting what I'm saying? All right, that's good right here, okay? And if we have a hunger and thirst for God, it will activate God's provision. We just saw that for you and your life. Seeking God's presence releases his blessings on you. Seeking God's presence, I'm saying the same thing over, just a different little way. Seeking God's presence releases his blessings on you. Let's look at Matthew 7:7 AMPC. And put up what you have if you don't have AMPC. We're going to read it from there. Going to read it from both translations right quick.
Ask and keep on asking.
Uh-huh.
And it will be given to you.
All right.
Seek and uh-huh. keep on seeking.
Did you see that? Not just seek one time and say, I can't find it. Oh, you got to listen to me. You got to pay attention to what I'm saying. It says ask and keep on asking. A lot of people ask and stop. And they ask, come on. And when they stop, they say, this not working. They says, I've tried this already and I can't, this doesn't seem to be happening for me. The scripture says to do what?
Ask and keep on asking.
Uh-huh.
And it will be given to you.
It will. Did you see the word will? Yeah. It will. That's enough to make you keep asking. Yeah. Read. Yeah.
Seek and keep on seeking.
What? Keep on seeking. Don't just stop because it didn't happen. Keep on seeking until it happens. Go.
And you will find.
And you will find.
Knock and keep on knocking.
Uh-huh.
And the door will be open to you.
The door will be open. Does it say the same thing? Read for me.
Keep on asking.
Uh-huh.
And it will be given to you.
Uh-huh.
Keep on seeking and you will find.
Uh-huh.
Keep on knocking reverently.
Reverently.
And the door will be open
and it will.
To you.
It will be. Anybody can agree that this has happened to you, that you prayed and nothing happened. But when you keep on praying, come on, something will break loose in the atmosphere for you. Something God has for you will come. Somebody say amen. I'm watching the clock. I'm going to give you another scripture. John 4, number 23 and 24, King James, very familiar.
But the hour cometh.
The hour cometh.
And now is.
And it's right now. Wait a minute. The hour is right now. The hour is right now. Wait a minute. The hour is right now. Why don't you look at the person next to you and tell them the hour is right now? The hour is right now. There is a time coming. Wait a minute. But it's right now. That.
Now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
Spirit and in truth. You can't worship God in your mind. You have to worship him in the spirit. Why is it that I got to worship God in the spirit? Because he is a spirit. We are in flesh and blood or in a body. We have to worship him in the spirit. Go for it.
But the Father seeketh such to
no,
worship him.
No, the Father is seeking people that know how to worship him. Amen. Not people that can just come to church.
Yeah.
Not people that can just greet a usher. Not people that could just preach or sing. Come on. He's looking for a true worshiper.
Yeah.
A true worshiper is somebody that knows how to open up and allow the presence of God to come in. Or somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody give God a shout this morning.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I'll give you one scripture and I'm sitting down. Philippians 4, 4 and 5 from the Message Bible. Philippians 4, 4 and 5 from the Message Bible. And this is my last scripture.
Celebrate God all day.
Celebrate him when? All day. Oh, I didn't hear everybody. Celebrate him when?
All day.
All day. Come on now. Read.
Every day.
Every day. Uh-huh.
I mean, revel in him.
Right. What does that mean? So I went to a dictionary. It means to carouse him or get drunk in him. That's what it means. Amen. It means that if you know how to get drunk without him, you need to know how to get drunk with him. Amen. You have to develop a taste for alcohol. You got to hear me. You do. You have to develop a taste for whatever it is that you're doing, but particularly alcohol, even cigarettes. You gotta develop a taste. When the first time you smoke a cigarette, you don't too much like that. First time you take a drink, come on, you don't too much like the way it tastes. But the more you do it, I ain't hear nobody in here. The more it's become a part of you, the more you begin to enjoy it, the more you begin to like it, then you're drunk. Anybody listening to me? Is that true or not? Right. So it's the same thing when you're entering in the presence of God, when you're worshiping God. Come on, you might not feel it right then. Oh, you got to press through that thing. You got to go harder. You got to go, come on, deeper in there. And the more you get in there, the more you will receive. You will be drunk by him. Somebody say hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. So I'm going to stop right here. Amen. I'm going to stop right here. And let's see what's next. Amen. So I'm going to give an altar call right now. If there's somebody in here, amen, that want to give your life to the Lord, it's time that you do it now. Somebody listening or viewing via the internet, amen. Then you also need to know that you can do it where you are, in your home, wherever you are. Amen. So the word of God says, amen, that you confess God and believe in your heart that you'll be saved. So Father, in the name of Jesus, amen, if that's you in the building, raise your hand. And if that's you via the internet, amen, this is your day. If you're in the building and you want to accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, lift your hands. And just in case there's somebody on the internet, repeat after me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that you will come into my life and you live. I give you praise for that. In Jesus' name, amen. If you are here at Charity Christian Center and you want to become a member, amen, then you can do that. Now, wait a minute. If you were online and you did text, amen, you can, and you did accept Christ. I'm sorry, I'm trying to go too fast. And you did accept Christ, you can text SAVED 871 to 94000. If you're in Charity Christian Center bodily, amen, you're here today, and you want to become a part of Charity Acts, that you will raise your hand. I'm going to tell you, this is the best church in the whole city of Baton Rouge. Amen. Lift your hands. Amen. And so if you're watching via the internet and you want to join Charity Christian Center, please text Join Charity to the number 94000. Why don't we give God a big shout for being in our presence today. Being in our presence today. Amen. You guys can take your seats. Amen. The Bible tells us that it is more blessing to give than it is to receive. And see, God wants us to be givers, but he wants us to be tithers also. And can I say to you this morning, amen, when you learn to give more than your tithes is when you will get blessed above the place that you're in right now. I'm going to say it again. When you learn to give more than your tithes is when you will be blessed above the place that you're in right now. Anybody want to get blessed above the place that they're in right now? Amen. Lift your hands. Let me see if I'm just talking or you listening to me. Do you believe where you are financially is where you're supposed to be? No. God has even more for us. So this morning, I want to share something with you. This morning, all this week and maybe a couple of months ago, some of the men and myself and my daughter, we've been looking at this parking lot out here. Brother Glenn Carey's been helping me. Brother Reg Grant has been helping me. Our parking lot looks a mess. Anybody could agree with me? Right. And so we've had somebody take a look at the parking lot, and the estimation, well, they gave me a real good estimation maybe about a month ago or 3 or 4 weeks ago, and I did not jump on it. It was really cheaper, but I didn't know to jump on it, okay? They just looking for some place to pour the concrete. So anyway, now we had somebody to come back, and so the price has gone up. Price gone up to $115,000. $115,000. We're going to get the parking lot paid. I just need you to know that. Amen. But I'm up here trying to get help, okay? And so not only did they tell me how much it would cost, but they also said it's not going to do you no good to get it paved because you don't have proper drainage on the property. And because we don't have the proper drainage, we had to call somebody to get an estimate on what it would cost to get the proper drainage put in. And it's no fault of ours. It was before our existence here. So the proper drainage, amen, one estimate, amen, that we have is like $10,000. So if I take that $115,000 and put it with the $10,000, that's going to give me what? $125,000. So I said, well, God, that's so big for me to ask people to, you know, to help us do. But God is bigger. Thank you. God said to me, if you give 25 people to give $5,000, that's all it would take. And that's over and above your tithes and offering. But guess, some people can do it. And God said, all I need is 25 people to give $5,000. Now, I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand or anything or go through that because God knows what's in your account. How many of y'all know God knows? He knows what's in your account. So I'm asking you, amen, that when you give, to give above your tithes. Don't just give your tithes, give above your tithes. I'm going to be one of the ones that's going to be give the $5,000. Why? Because pastors lead by example. And so perhaps you can't do five and you can do 25. Is that right? Half? 25. And if you can do the 25, do the 25. Maybe somebody else will do the other 25. And if you can't do that, do whatever you can do. Is that okay? Y'all hear me what I'm saying? So if you would go to Giblify, and I don't have anything for text to give, but this morning I did go to Giblify, and I put on Giblify parking lot and drainage. So when you go to the app, you will see it. Please put your tithes and then go to the parking lot and drainage and help your church get that parking lot paid. Amen. Somebody say amen. Amen. I'm not begging. Come on. Anything, I'm just stating a fact. Amen. So we need to get it taken care of. So I bring it to the body of Christ and ask that you guys would help. Amen. And so it's time to give. Those of you that are giving, amen, you go to Giblify with three ways to give. Amen. You can text to give to the number 225-314-5577. You can go to the Giblify app and you will find that you will a parking, you will see parking lot and drainage on there. You should see that on there. If you are giving here in the sanctuary, we ask that you will get an envelope and perhaps you can put the extra money for others. Is there a place on there that says other? Not for text to give, but for Giblify. Nah, for your envelope. I'm sorry. It has others on your envelope. Yeah, you can write the word right there, or you could just check that right there, and all that will be good. If you are mailing it in, mail it in to 871 O'Neill Lane, Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 70816. So I'm going to let Terrell play a song, and somebody's going to come and get you to stand up, And we're going to come around with all those, for all those people that have envelopes. Amen. You're going to put it in the basket this morning. I love you guys. You be blessed in the Lord.
God, for everyone that gave this morning, Father God. Lord, we know you're a God of multiplication, Father God. We thank you, Lord God, that you multiply every seed sown, Father God. Lord, you're also a miracle God, Father God. Perform the miracle now, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord God. We give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Can you give it up for the word this morning? Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. The anointing has been in this place all morning, man. Hallelujah. We're getting ready to dedicate a baby back to the Lord. Amen. We want everybody that's associated with the baby, Aiden Alexander, to come on up front. Come on, let's give it up for this family as they come up. Hallelujah. What a joy and an honor to dedicate a child back to the Lord. Amen. You just stand right in front of me, face me. Amen. Yeah, bring the little man in the center. There you go. All right. So the baby dedication is a wonderful moment in which parents make a public statement of faith to raise their child under God's grace and wisdom. Dedicating your child to God shows that you recognize your child as a gift from God and you are dedicating yourself to being a godly example to your child. Baby dedication does not secure salvation, rather it is a symbolic moment entrusting the child's life to God's will. So this morning we're getting ready to dedicate baby Aiden Alexander to the Lord. In 1 Samuel, it talks about Hannah, and that's the first recognition we have of someone dedicating a baby or christening, dedicating the baby back to the Lord. So Hannah prayed really, really hard. She wanted a child so bad, and it was just so tough for her to have a child. So she told God, God, if you bless me with the child, I promise I will dedicate him back to you. It was a struggle for Hannah to have the baby, but it wasn't a struggle for Hannah to dedicate the baby back to the Lord. Somebody should have said amen right there. In Jeremiah chapter 1, verse number 5, it's in the Message translation. It says, before Aiden was shaped in your womb, I knew all about him. Before you saw the light, before he opened his eyes, God said, I had holy plans for him. A prophet to the nations, that's what I have in mind for little Aiden. Jeremiah 29 and 11, the Message translation says, I know what I'm doing. This is God talking. He said, I know what I'm doing. I have it all planned out. plans to take care of you, not abandon you, plan to give you the future you hope for. One more scripture, Proverbs 22:6, King James Version says, train up a child in the way he should go. This is a King James Version. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. The Message translation says it this way. It says, point your child in the right direction, and when they're old, they won't be lost. So as godparents, you're saying that, hey, look, I know Aiden got to come up in a godly way. So if the parents not doing, as godparents, I'm going to make sure that he's connected to God. See, being a godparent is just not a title. It's a commitment to saying, hey, I'm going to be there. I'm going to make sure he know right from wrong. He going to get good godly directions. Amen? Amen. So I just want to pray for Aiden. I'm going to get my wife to anoint his head for me. We just want to pray for him. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you right now for little Aiden Alexander, Father God. Lord, we lift him up this morning, Father God. Lord, we thank you, Lord God. He's blessed because you called him blessed, Father God. Lord, I thank you that every need, Lord God, is met, Father God, throughout his youth, Father God, until he's an adult, Father God. Thank you for your hand of protection surrounding him, Father God. Everything his hand touched prospers, Father God. He's smart, Father God. He's intelligent, and he has every need met, Father God. I thank you right now for everyone in this family, Lord God, that's standing in agreement with Aiden, Father God. I thank you, Lord God, that they're blessed, Father God. Lord, I thank you right now that all of their needs are met, Father God. And I thank you, Lord God, they're on one accord, Father God. One accord to see that Aiden, Father God, prosper in every area of his life, Father God. I thank you right now, God, that you say, dedicate the child to you, Father God. And you will make sure that he prosper, Father God. And I thank you right now, you be with him every step of the way, Father God, that his journey will be complete in you, Father God. And we give you glory and we give you honor. And we thank you this morning, Father God. We dedicate him back to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can I get a little hug, Aiden? God bless you. God bless you. Bless you. So glad standing in. God bless you. Bless you. It's always good when family stand in. God bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Yeah, we just want to read the certificate that we have this morning.
All right, this is a certificate of christening. This certifies that Aiden Makai Alexander, child of Dan Alexander and Arnisha Bess, born at Woman's Hospital on September 19, 2019, was christened here at Charity Christian Center on today's date of the 22nd day of May, in 2022, and it is signed by Justin and Crystal Johnson, along with our pastor, Dr. Linda Branford. Amen.
So the journey don't just start right, it starts right now, but the journey is a long journey. So I expect everybody to be there to help lift Aiden up the whole way. Amen. God bless you guys. Come on, let's give it up for this family. Come on, give it up. Hallelujah.
Amen. As we get ready to dismiss, just a couple of announcements.